Academy. Welcome to another educational video. I was asked, hey Ivan, show us a really cool razor technique. Got anything really neat you can share? I've got tons of them. And here's one of my favorites. When we're working with bob shapes, we work very hard to cut it with an under bevel so it will roll under. We work very hard to blow dry it with an under bevel so it will roll under. I'm going to give you one quick tip or trick using our feather texture razor and texture razor layer, texturizing blade, to really encourage that hair to kick under beautifully every time. And it's called rolling under. Here's what I'm gonna do. I've got no blade in my razor. I'm gonna demo it without a blade, then I'm gonna show you what it looks like. We're going to be rotating underneath the hair at the base of the bob between my razor and my comb. Notice that rolling motion. I'm drawing the hair through the comb along the spine. I use a wide tooth comb for my razor cutting. I'm doing that, and then I'm inserting my razor, and I'm using the back of my razor, the spine of the razor. There's no blade in here. And I'm rolling like that. It's similar to how I might roll a round brush in a blow dryer. And what I'm gonna do as I'm rolling, I'm gonna begin to rotate the razor up. And as I roll under here and rotate the razor up, the blade is facing down. Think about a clock. 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 3 o'clock. I'm gonna roll, and I'm gonna roll from 6 to 7 to 8 to 9 to 10. And when I get to about 10, all of a sudden the razor will begin to gradually catch hair. When I get to 11, it'll catch a little more. If I get to 12, it'll catch even more. It's about the idea of position, not pressure. It's not how hard you push with a razor, it's the angle of the blade relative to the haircut. So it's gonna look like this. I'm gonna come up and under, and I'm gonna roll. Now I'm to the point where the blade is pointing straight up. And what it's gonna do, it's gonna etch some hair from the underside, creating short hair underneath the long, and I can comb it without forcing it with a blow dryer. The hair is just gonna kick under beautifully. Let's put a blade in and see how this works. We're gonna use our Blade Glide Plus to keep the hair moisturized and hydrated so we get wonderful slip and slide, and so this aids in client comfort. Now, I would have already cut my bob shape, whether I cut it with my feather switchblade shears or whether I cut my bob with my traditional feather razor, and as I worked through from wet, the hair would have begun to dry down. I don't want this to be uncomfortable for the client, so the hydration is gonna be important. I'm gonna grab my texture razor blade, my texturizing razor blades. I've got a razor on, a blade on there now. I'm going to come in and I'm underneath, and right now I'm running on the back of the spine of the razor. There's no cutting happening. But as I get to 10 o'clock, all of a sudden, you'll start to see some hair fall away, and you'll start, the client can feel some hair catching under there as I'm taking hair from the underside of my bob. I'm just rolling the two tools, and then you can see a little bit of hair catching, scraping, and coming away from the underside. I'm not taking length away, and I'm not layering. Two important issues of bob cutting. I didn't take length away, and I didn't layer. And now, when I comb that, it literally just begins to roll under on its own. If I hit that lightly with a brush and a dryer, that bob's gonna kick under beautifully, even if I didn't do a good job of cutting the under bevel. Look how that sits and how it rolls under like that. Rolling under with our razor, moving the razor up and rolling under to gently etch from inside, creating the short hairs that allow the kick. I'm Ivan Zoot for Jatai Academy. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.